just wouldn't be the holiday season without a new movie starring Dean Cain.
He has made not one, not two, but 16 Christmas films, and he'll be starting production on his 17th next month. His latest is called Merry Xmas.
You're running out of titles.
No way.
He plays a bodyguard who gets accused of having an affair, of course, with his pop star client.
Oh, no.
Have we not seen that before?
No.
Anyway,
accused.
And despite his denials, his ex-wife doesn't believe it.
Let's see it.
As well, she shouldn't.
I just think you need something more sophisticated.
Thank you.
Just keep it simple.
I want simple.
You want escape?
Escape from what?
Do you want a list?
Well, put your name at the tippy top.
How about I put a six-letter word up there? A-F-F-A-I-R.
Never happened.
Be honest.
I am.
Liar.
You just can't admit it.
What?
That I did not have an affair. You can't admit that.
I don't have to, because you did.
A picture is not proof. Mm-hmm. You just can't be wrong.
Oh, because I'm always right.
I'm sorry, but that's snappy dialogue.
That's real life.
Well, Christy and I have done a number of films together. We're great friends, and it wasn't hard to get that
groove.
Quick
that,
snap.
Yeah,
sometimes she would cut me off, too, and I, you know.
Like in a real relationship. Yeah. Like Hoda's in mine.
Yeah, right, exactly. So wait, was there proof of the affair? Was like a photo?
There was a photograph, but a photo can be, you know, it can be cropped.
Yes.
It could omit a lot of other things.
Yes.
And my character was just too proud to really show her everything. And,
okay.
and so he didn't say anything. He thought she should believe him just based on his words. And they drifted apart. And they get caught and they get sort of stuck many years later in a cabin they share. They get snowed in like Buffalo got snowed in a few weeks ago.
Yeah. Now, didn't you write this with a couple of friends? Something happened. What happened?
We were sitting in a coffee shop and we were talking about what kind of Christmas movie to make. It was a lot of fun. We had made one the year before for Ion Television as well. And we were saying, what should we do? What would be fun to do? So we came up with a concept, pitched it to them, and they said, make the movie.
And it's a family affair. You got your mom in it. You have your son in it.
It's
hello.
It's Christmas. It's family. It must
what
be.
What does your, oh, she's darling. What's your mom play?
My mom plays my disapproving mother-in-law, ex-mother-in-law. Well, I say it's typecasting.
It's not a stretch.
She hadn't done anything in a while, and she was a little nervous to act. I go, Mom, you're just going to play yourself disapproving of me. It's perfect.
Was she an actress?
She is an actress.
Okay.
So she was very good.
And what about your son? You beam when you talk about him every time.
That's my man. He's in the film. He wanted to say that just very simple. Make it something simple. So he's in this pool scene. He has one line. He practiced it a few times.
Okay.
I wasn't even there the day he shot, which is probably better.
Probably. Comfortable?
But he was great.
Yeah.
He was fantastic. He liked it. I don't know if he wants to be an actor, but he certainly comes to visit the set on Hit the Floor.
Yeah.
Where I have 14 dancers aged 20 to 24 or 26 or whatever they are.
More perfect than the next.
Yeah, and so he shows up on that set all the time.
I wonder why.
I'm trying to figure it out.
Hello. Now, you're in your, what, fourth season of Hit the Floor?
We're going into our third season. To start with, but I'm glad it feels like four. That's
it
great.
Does.
We've been around for a while.
Yeah.
We start in February. I love that show. It's a joy to go to work every day. And it's also a reason to want to make you get to the gym because those guys are in great shape.
All right, since you are the king of Christmas movies, we want to.
You're not going to ask him about Brooke?
Oh, yeah, Brooke. We have to talk about Brooke. That's more important. Okay, you're right. Tell us about Brooke.
Brooke is a wonderful, wonderful girl. We were college sweethearts, and she's obviously written a book.
Yeah.
I gotta be honest, I haven't read the whole book. I haven't even gotten to the part where she talks about us, but it's really insightful for me. I mean, we had discussed a lot of the things with her mother, and obviously her mother and I sometimes, you know, butted heads. It was really interesting to see how that all began because we didn't really get into that during our relationship. And so I found it to be really raw.
But she does say in the book that she lost her virginity to you. Is that what she says in the book?
I don't know if those are the exact words.
Yeah. Yes, it is.
I never think a girl loses
her virginity. She was on my podcast.
Virginity.
Yes, it is.
They give it.
Not well. You know what? She says it was everything you would wish for your own daughter.
Wow.
Well, we were in love. I mean, she was a wonderful girl.
You stay
girl.
Away from mine, all right?
She's in L.A.
She is. We love you, and we're excited for your 16th, and we are waiting with bated breath for your 17th.
When's it happening? Merry Xmas premieres this Sunday on Ion Television.